Cigarette? Where are the bodies? Where are they? Look, you know you did it. I know you did it. I promise you, you will break tonight. I guarantee it. Dr. Brussel.
Commissioner Farlow asked me to take part in this process, given that my expertise is in cases such as this.
This is Marlowe's unit, not mine.
Now, Mr. Henley, yes? Now, Mr. Henley, are you aware that you're being accused of killing...
We know you did it! We know it!
Mr. Voller.
What? He has no defense, no alibi. You were at the scene of the crime. You were carrying the weapon. You had their blood on your hands. Don't give me any of this I don't remember bull. I won't let you do it.
Please, Mr. Voller.
We don't need the bodies to put you away, so you might as well tell us.
Jefferson Cameron Voller, 24 years old. Married young, his high school sweetheart.
He's got three kids. Keeps the gun under the mattress. Keeps the wife's love letters in the bookcase downstairs. I know you. I know your face.
Henley!
You psychopathic little... How do you know?
I can do better. You're smart. You're smarter than most. Graduated the academy with honors. But you couldn't cut it on the street. This case is your last shot. You don't have a family connection, and your daddy can't get your own job.
Where are the bodies?
You know, I'm really no more insane than you are. When you break it down. When you look really deep. When you peel that scab off. We're not so different.
Don't you dare compare yourself to me! I am nothing like you!
Everyone is like us.
You're wrong! People aren't like that! I'm not like that!
Henley.
Doctor!
Detective, please. Now, Henley, you said that in the past, you killed people because you enjoyed it. Is that true in this case?
No. No, I didn't enjoy it this time. But it had to be done.
Why did it have to be done?
You know, you're right, Detective. We're not all like us. The doctor here, he's a smart man. An intelligent man. A man of learning.
Mr. Henley, please answer the question.
Yes, he's a smart man. He knows what goes on. He knows men like us, but never would he become one.
Doctor, seriously, let me do my job. You can't fix him.
They still haven't found the bodies. They still haven't found your family, Mr. Boulder. Your lovely wife. That was indeed a tragedy. I don't know what I would have done with myself if I walked in on that scene.
Where are they? Oh, I think you know.
Stop playing games with me and tell me where they are, you perverted little piece of-
Why should I stop? Life is a game.
Detective, I need you to remember back to that day.
Yes, Detective, what are your favorite hiding places?
What?
The well in back of the woods, the loft in your neighbor's barn.
We already searched there.
Detective, you must think. You must remember.
I know. Hide them someplace where they would never be found. The foundation of the house.
Under construction next door.
See? I'm a smart man too.
Then you did it! Admit it! You killed them! Why?
Why not? Of course I killed them.
Yes! And you will burn for it! Where did he go? Where did he go? What did you do with him?
Mr. Henley, please answer the question.
Yes, he is a smart man. He knows what goes on. He knows about people like us, but he would never become one.
Doctor, please, let me do my job. You can't fix him.
You know, I really am no more insane than you are, Jefferson. When you look really deep, when you peel back that scab, you and I really aren't that different.
We are very different, you and I. I am nothing like you!
Everyone is like us.
Don't you dare compare yourself to me! I am nothing like you!
No, I didn't enjoy it. But it had to be done.
Silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you can't afford an attorney will be provided for you.